and welcome you to St. Thomas, and I do hope you enjoy your stay here today. You notice we drive at the left-hand side, and the reason why we're driving on the left, this was a British influence. The Wilson Fort, the British Islands, which are located on the northeastern side of St. Thomas. The language of Tobago Island is just Van Dyke and Tartu.
This is the Havenside Mall.
The mall a while ago. It's a 2.5 miles from here to downtown. And the price is also comparable. So basically, if you, after the tour, you just want to hang around here, it's not a bad idea. St. Thomas is the capital of the U.S. Virgin Islands. The square Charlotte Mall is St. Thomas, and the island is 32 square miles. The largest of the U.S. Virgin Islands is St. Croix, which are located 40 miles to the south of St. Thomas, and St. Croix is 84 square miles. We got St. John's, which are located 4 miles east of St. Thomas. And St. John's is 19.5 square miles. So including with the three main, actually there's another island that we're going to see. It's in the inner harbor, which is called Water Island. So including with the four populated islands, there are 42 islands of the U.S. Virgin Islands. After the completion of the sale of Denmark, the people were given 10 years that to decide if they want to go back to Denmark and if they want to stay as American citizens. They had a privilege for 10 years. Our main source of income in the Virgin Islands is tourism, which started in October until the end of April. As you guys know, we didn't do much October, now November. Cardozo was our terrified months when we had two storm hit us in September, Hurricane Oma and Hurricane Maria. So we had a lot of cleanup to do. Couldn't take my ship to my boat. We got everything together. Some of the street lights were destroyed in the signal. Couple of intersections don't have none yet. Just had to go back to the old time one, go to a ship to provide them with a room. Availability in the hotel was small. Most of a major hotel we got damaged and still closed down. But our room depending right now the ships. So we got you, we glad to have you here. We hope you enjoy your day here and you will come back again. Tropical weather, we get service also, we get short showers. We average 35 to 40 inches of rain per day, per year. The day came in when you could get a short shower just about every day here. And for the after the half storm, it's been raining every day. A short shower, nothing to disturb the whole thing. Okay. The building on the water, that's our capital building, was built in 1874. The red one across from it is Fort Christian. Fort Christian was built in 1671. It was named after King Christian III. The first thing that building was used for, it was a prison. Just after they built one, and the inside of this building right here, it's a peace building next to the courthouse and the police station. This is a federal building in itself. from 1917 until 1938. This island was run by the Navy from 1938 to 1972. The island was run by the Interior Department within that time. The President of the United States used to appoint governors to the U.S. Up until now. Every 2 years, we elect district senators, which is 7 represent St. Thomas, 7 represent St. Croix, and 1 represent St. John's. We also elect 1 Congress rep. Potholes after the storm, we lose a lot of roads and potholes, but trying the best to see what I can do again. Sometimes just gets so rough. You know, I slow it down. Should go to St. Croix, despite it's the largest. The St. Croix is flat, like we always say, St. Croix is flat like a pancake. It's worth inside is yet heaven run. In 1995, we had a storm called Hurricane Marilyn, and the Ramada Hotel was here. It was taken down to the level I cannot put on, rebuilt. We break everything down and build. So investor came in and built Yacht Haven Grand, including with Marina. And some stores, Louboutin and some office, doctor's office. Louboutin and Gucci on the other side. Trip and get back home safely, and please come again.